Welcome back to the California Gardener. Today I just wanted to show you some of our produce that we're growing here in the backyard. It's been a quick spring and summer's here. I haven't really done a lot of videos, so I'm sorry, but the stuff still is growing like crazy. I'll give you a little panorama view. You see my pumpkins are all spread out all over, taking over the yard again. We just got back from a 2-week vacation. And now we're here, everything's growing. You see the tomatoes are super high, more squash, some peas and other stuff didn't do so great since I planted a little later this year, too busy to plant earlier. But check out this little bowl. Just got home, needed something to eat, so take a walk around the garden. Found some beautiful bell peppers, some really nice super ripe tomatoes, some crooked neck yellow squash ready to eat there. And this is a nice young zucchini here. This is a different variety. It's kind of more like a bell-shaped one. Really nice for eating as well. I also had picked a few others that were really big. But so why am I showing you this? The importance of a timed watering system for your garden is huge when you go on vacation. Because how else will you plant a garden and leave for vacation and come home and expect to find this when you left and there was nothing in the garden? Well, a timed watering system is super important here in Southern California, as it is really hot in the summertime and things dry out very fast. So even if you use a mulching system, plastic mulch or a natural organic mulch, the soil will dry out. So you need to have pre-planned. Either you have a sprinkler system, a drip line, a big, you know, regular old sprinkler that goes back and forth. But whatever you do have should be on timer. And just to be on the safe side, when I'm on vacation, I tend to set the timer to overwater a little bit. I'd rather have things be a little overwatered rather than dry out and die on me. Because usually when you come back, you still find a few dry spots in your garden where things overgrew on the sprinkler, and then you have a dry spot. So let me go show you like what happened to my garden in one spot. So we have this major pumpkin growth. Everything is growing good. And then I think something overgrew the sprinkler over here. You see these tomatoes super high? They're loaded with tomatoes. Look at that, all over the place. Big giant tomatoes. And then we come down to the end here. Look at these. These tomatoes are loaded, but the leaves are kind of yellowish brown. There's still tomatoes on them, but I think I watered. Now, this very end here, I think kind of got cornered off from the water and the plants started to die. So I didn't realize this was going to be a dry spot, because usually water shoots from the back there underneath the grapes, but these pumpkins must have grown up so high they are blocking the water from getting to these plants. So, you know, it's hard to foresee that. No big deal, because I plant a lot of stuff. But just remember, when you're going on vacation and you want to